joined by Tom and Joel of Silent Screams. How you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you very much. Now, first of all, you guys released your new album, Hope for Now, earlier this year. What was that like recording?
It was a lot of fun. We did a lot of it ourselves, so it was quite a relaxed environment, and we got to kind of, you know, go over things a lot and scrutinize every single point of it.
It was a lot different from the last time. The first album we did, When It Rains, we went over to the States, did that with Joey Sturges. That was in like a month, so it was, although it was still relaxed, it was all very time limited, whereas this, we got to take our time. It was a bit more difficult, I will say. We didn't have that sort of outside perspective at hand all the time, but yeah, we're really pleased with the outcome, so it's good stuff.
Now, you've just announced a tour coming up with Crossfaith. How did that come about? Because they're a pretty cool Japanese band.
Yeah, they're wicked. We're looking forward to that. Well, basically, originally we had the Attila tour, the Guilty Pleasure tour, and that they got offered the Black Veil Brides tour. So that tour's been postponed, which we're really quite bummed out about. And I think they were sort of looking for bands, Crossfaith were, and I think we were considered, but they were like, no, they're doing the Attila tour. And a couple of other bands, I think, Capture the Crown and I See Stars, turned it down, so they're just far to us.
When we kind of got notified that the Attila tour had been postponed, they were like, oh, well, we can offer it them now, and that's kind of how it came about.
Now, is there any particular place you're looking forward to playing most on this tour?
I think the Coco in London's been mentioned a lot.
Yeah, I mean, that seems to see some form of prestigious venue.
Mice and Men have played there,
any of them. I'm looking forward to them all.
Yeah, so. Looking forward to the tour in general. Like, it's, you know, because with the Attila tour, it was, although it was with like a bigger band, it's, you know, it's venues we've played before, you know, which we're always happy to do and looking forward to. Because people have seen this before will come back, but obviously, you know, we want to be constantly doing bigger things, so it's generally just like a bit of a step up.
That gradual step up's nice.
Ready
as well
to take it on.
Now, aside from the UK, is there anywhere particular you'd love to tour, anywhere in the world or anywhere that you've been that you particularly enjoyed most?
States. I'd love to tour America.
Yeah. That's on the cards as well.
Go back to Australia.
Australia is sort of like our second home, and we've been there twice. First time was before we had like an album out or anything. It was just because we had a general sort of hype going, so we just like sort of took a leap of faith, went over there, toured with some bands. Is that one of the bands is actually Buried in Verona, who we're now on the same label with and really good friends with. So they invited us out again, and yeah, we just generally, we have a lot of friends over there, have a good fan base, so yeah, looking forward to going back there again, definitely. But anywhere in general, like, you know, we love UK, we love Europe, and yeah.
Now, where do you draw your influence from for your music? Is there any particular bands that you particularly idolise or draw from?
Slipknot. Everyone loves Slipknot. Yeah. You can't not like Slipknot.
I think there's just so many. It's,
we all. The cool thing is though, because we all have like a lot of influences. Like there's a lot of bands that we can all draw together. Like you some stuff that I don't really particularly know of or like. Yeah. And same, and say, you know, Sam will like his stuff, and we just kind of.
So like, if you were to ask our guitarists and probably our drummer as well, where they're influenced, they'd say things like Deftones, Parkway Drive. You know, which you could probably hear that in a lot of our stuff, but. You know, I grew up idolizing people like, because I sing, like people like Dallas Green, that sort of thing. So, you know, my influences are coming from that side of thing. But it depends on, you know, like we were listening to at the time. Like when we were recording, I was listening to Semper Eternal like every single day. So there's no doubt I've been influenced by that massively. And I'm sure you're the same. Would have listened to things that were.
To be honest, at the time I was just listening to that album over
you have to
and over
listen
again.
To that as well.
Now, aside from the tour with Crossfaith, what's next on the cards for you guys?
We've got a few things in the line that we can't really talk about, though.
Yeah.
That's such a crap.
It's always the way, though, isn't it?
Things, we can say that America is happening. We can't really announce what it is we're going to be doing over there yet, but it's definitely on the cards for 2015. The Attila tour again, and hopefully some kind of our own headline tour will definitely happen. Yeah,
yeah, hopefully we'll get some booked up after the Crossfaith one, maybe, whether it just be a small one.
And definitely Australia, because kids just keep on wanting us to go back. And if we don't go there as a band, I'll just go there anyway. So.
Three guys.
Yeah, I just love it so much.
Now, a bit of a fun question I always like to ask. Do you guys remember the MTV Celebrity Deathmatch show?
Yeah, I used to.
Right.
if you could fight anyone on that, could be friend, could be foe, anyone, who would it be, and how would you end it? Would you be the person that wins, or would you lose? What would happen?
I think, I don't know why, but Hulk Hogan just came into my mind. I don't have like a general hate for him, but...
Yeah. Well, you don't have to have a general hate for anyone. It could be your best mate.
And I'd like it to end with me shaving his beard off and taking his bandana off and hitting it with him. Just fucking in the face, like...
I would probably fight Tom Cruise, because I hate Tom Cruise. I hate that guy. Like, I can't even really justify it, I just hate him.
Fair enough.
It's just deep with him.
Yeah, it's just really deep inside me. I hate Tom Cruise. So I'd probably... I don't care who wins. I just want the ability to fight him.
You haven't got any particular funny way it might end?
No, I just want him to be in a lot of pain and accept what he's done. Just accept the fact that I don't like him.
Fair enough. Anyway, thank you very much for chatting to Total Rock today. I hope you enjoy the rest of Breakout Festival, and thank you.